observes Kongzongde, recalls the martyrs of Manipur, and no power supply at various places in Manipur after yesterday's storm. The news in detail. Manipur observed Kongzongde Day to commemorate the last battle of independence fought against the mighty British on April 23rd in the year 1891 at Kebaching, Kongzong in Thoubal district. The last resistance was crushed by the British army, after which the Union Jack was hoisted at Kangla, the then capital of Manipur. Chief Minister O. Ibobi, ministers, MLAs, high-ranking officials of civil and police, and people coming from different parts of the state took part in the observance. A mass floral tribute was paid, led by the Chief Minister, to the martyrs at Kebaching, where the last battle of independence was fought by the Manipuri soldiers. No power supply at various places in Manipur after yesterday's storm. Most of the electric poles at different places are uprooted and electric wires are also damaged by the storm. Besides, the towers which carry the HT line are also destroyed. When a team of ISTV News visited at Kangchub area, most of the electric poles are found uprooted and the electric wire are found breakage due to branches of tree fall at the wire. On the other hand, in the areas of Imphal city, electric wires are also found breakage due to numbers of GI sheets and branches of tree fall at the wires by storm. Small-scale industries and establishments have been down their shutters as no power supply. In the meanwhile, as today is general holiday, staff of Manipur State Power Company Limited and Manipur State Power Distribution Company Limited have begun to repair the damages and make available the power to the people. However, it is yet to be known what time to be taken to restore, repair and install the damaged electric poles, breakage wire and reinstall devastated towers. Another 30 houses also destroyed by yesterday's rainstorm at Kangchub Chiru village under Saitu Gamphazol block in Senapati district too. Banana farms and other cash crops fields have been destroyed. A team of ISTB News inspected the site today and found out the damages. Talking to the ISTB News, General Secretary of Kangchub Chiru Youth Club, Jasua, said, "It is very unfortunate for the villagers." He drew the attention of the local MLA and the state government to look into the matter and do the needful at the earliest.
Rang nong le nong sit lap sida yum nong amadi heira hai pham mayam lapoi gi pham mayam su lusin gre taktuk gre nong sit sina aduga yum su kunitoi kuhun boi muksi thudai gre thugai gre dana sanbini na yar gati koi sarkar gi mi sina koi gi mateng gre taubir gati.
On the other hand, altogether 10 houses at Lamboing Kongrangkong and Iroshemba have been completely destroyed by yesterday's storm. Member of Watch No. 27, Meng Lim, has visited the areas today. He gave some aids to the house owners. Speaking to media persons, Meng Lim said, "It's a natural calamity." However, he drew the attention of the authority concerned to look into the matter and provide financial or any types of aid be available to the victims.
Ibadi Loken MLA koi onere MLA amadi concern minister jing marine reba department singda aiba awana tar visit jing asida mieng changbi dana aidi pibe yaba mateng pibiu haiduna aina ngasi mayang ngut silaga ISTB gi khudangda mayang phonda aina haijeri.
Meanwhile, Terakhuraizam Lairak has been blocked following the fallen down of three big trees during the storm. Besides, electric power lines at the Lekai was also damaged by the trees. Therefore, no power supply at the Lekai from yesterday. Many houses near the roadside was also destroyed by the storm. The volunteers of the local club, KRYPSA, and residents of the Lekai are trying to clear the road. Talking to the ISTV News, a resident of the Lekai drew the attention of the authority concerned to look into the matter and do the needful for the damage and grievances facing by the residents at the earliest. A team of Imphal West Police Commando today conducted a search operation at Nupakaitel. 20 persons who do not able to produce the proof for their identities were picked up and handed over to the city police for further verification. Adhyaksha of Imphal East, P. Bimola Devi, today inaugurated a newly constructed Ibudau Marching Sanglen at Kontha Achangbigay. The inauguration function was organized by Ibudau Marching Lai Committee. DC of Imphal East, M. Joy, ADM K. Lakshmikanta, Upa Pradhan P. Sundar, President of Lai Committee Y. Chauba, many locals attended the inaugural function. Speaking at the function, Adhyaksha Bimola Devi said, "Marjing is one of the oldest forest deity." She further said, "The new building is being constructed as the existing one is outdated. Besides, the new building inaugurated today will be remained a long-lasting one," she added. A blessing-seeking ceremony of Nilahari Film Productions, Manipuri Digital Film, Aikhoi Pabungi, was held at Image Studio. Chairman of Film Forum Manipur, L. Surjakanta Sharma, editor of Image, a monthly film magazine, Ranjan, and many artists attended the ceremony. Bigyan Hidang Mayum is the producer, while Hemanta Kuman is directing the film. Bala, Tonthoi, and many renowned artists are taking the lead roles. And moving on to some national international news. The last rites of farmer Gajendra Singh, who committed suicide at the Aam Aadmi Party rally yesterday in New Delhi, were conducted at his native village in Dausa in Rajasthan in the presence of a large number of villagers, but just a few politicians, even as parliament debated the tragedy with leaders from almost every party expressing their shock and anger over the tragedy. While the blame game between political parties is underway, no leader from the Bharatiya Janata Party or the Aam Aadmi Party attended the last rites, even though Rajasthan Congress Chief Sachin Pilot, along with former Rajasthan Chief Minister Ashok Gehlot, was present there. According to officials, the body was taken to Rajgarh in Alwar district, which is 30 km away from his village Nangal Jamarwada village in Dausa district of Rajasthan on Wednesday night. The body was taken for cremation in a large procession. Meanwhile, Prime Minister Narendra Modi met his senior ministers over the issue. Delhi Police Commissioner B.S. Basi also handed over a preliminary report to Home Minister Rajnath Singh. Rajasthan farmer Gajendra Singh, who hanged himself in front of thousands at an Aam Aadmi Party rally on Wednesday, was not the sort to commit suicide, says his shell-shocked family. Gajendra's farm had not been so badly damaged, said his relatives, and he was not in dire financial crisis. The Jammu and Kashmir government today booked hardline separatist Masarat Alam under the Public Safety Act PSA and shifted him to a jail outside the valley. Yes, PSA warrants were issued against Masarat Alam and the warrants were executed. He is being shifted for detention to a jail outside the valley, a senior police officer told IANS in summer capital Srinagar. Masarat Alam was released on March 7 by the PDP-BJP coalition government, triggering a huge controversy over the separatist release who had been arrested during the 2010 summer unrest in the valley. The Union Cabinet has cleared a proposal to try juveniles in the age group of 16 to 18 years who are accused of heinous crimes under laws for adults. It cleared the amendment to the Juvenile Justice Act in this regard during a meeting in New Delhi last evening. The proposed new law gives the Juvenile Justice Board the power to assess whether the perpetrator of a heinous crime aged between 16 and 18. The Calbuco volcano in southern Chile was erupted twice in the space of a few hours, having lain dormant for decades. Footage from the area shows a huge column of lava and ash being sent several kilometers into the air. The authorities have declared a red alert and evacuated more than 4,000 people within a 20-kilometer radius. The Calbuco volcano is one of the most active in Chile, but its eruption took officials in the area by surprise. Alejandro Vergis, an emergency director for the region, said Calbuco had not been under any special form of observation. An experimental drug has cured monkeys infected with the Ebola virus, U.S.-based scientists have said. The treatment, known as TMK Ebola Guinea, targets the Makona strain of the virus, which caused the current deadly outbreak in West Africa. All three monkeys receiving the treatment were healthy when the trial ended after 28 days. Three untreated monkeys died within 9 days. Scientists caution that the drug's efficacy has not been proven in humans. At present, there are no treatments or vaccines for Ebola that have been proven to work in humans. And before we signed off, the top stories once again. States observed Gongsun Day recalls the martyrs of Manipur. And no power supply at various places in Manipur after yesterday's storm. Well, thank you so much for joining with us and stay tuned for more news.